Welcome back. Today we are going to discuss an AP Biology question. The link to this question has been given in the description of the video. All the resources links are given in the video description as well. The question is, malonate is a competitive inhibitor of the respiratory enzyme succinate dehydrogenase in the following reaction. Succinate is getting converted to fumarate. Succinate dehydrogenase is the enzyme and malonate is a competitive inhibitor. Which of the following choices best describes the best way to determine whether malonate is a competitive or a non-competitive inhibitor of succinate dehydrogenase? A. In the presence of malonate, increase the concentration of succinate, the substrate. If the rate of reaction increases, then malonate is a competitive inhibitor. B. In the presence of malonate, increase the concentration of succinate, the substrate. If the rate of reaction increases, then malonate is a non-competitive inhibitor. C. Malonate can alternate between a competitive and non-competitive inhibitor depending on what is required. D. A coenzyme must be affecting the rate of the reaction. I will suggest you to pause the video here and try to figure out the problem by yourself. Hope by now you already have figured it out. Let us just now discuss it together. So, in order to answer this question, we will have to know what is a competitive inhibitor, what is a non-competitive inhibitor, what is a coenzyme, how the rate of the enzyme catalyst reactions are affected, etc. So, this is Biochemistry 5th edition by Strier. You can get these books from NCBI resources. Let me just read out the important portions here. The activity of many enzymes can be inhibited by the binding of specific small molecules and ions. This means of inhibiting enzyme activity serves as a major control mechanism in biological systems. Enzyme inhibition can be either reversible or irreversible. An irreversible inhibitor dissociates very slowly from its target enzyme because it has become tightly bound to the enzyme either covalently or non-covalently. Some irreversible inhibitors are important drugs. Example, penicillin acts by covalently modifying the enzyme transpeptidase, thereby preventing the synthesis of bacterial cell walls and thus killing the bacteria. So here they discussed about the irreversible inhibitor and given an example. Now coming to the reversible inhibition. Reversible inhibition, in contrast with irreversible inhibition, is characterized by a rapid dissociation of the enzyme inhibitor complex. In competitive inhibition, that what we want to know, an enzyme can bind substrate forming an enzyme substrate complex or inhibitor forming an enzyme inhibitor complex, but not both. So in competitive inhibition, the enzyme is binding either to the substrate or to the inhibitor, but it cannot bind to both. The competitive inhibitor resembles the substrate and binds to the active site of the enzyme. The substrate is thereby prevented from binding to the active site. Let us just visualize this. So this is the enzyme. This is the active site of the enzyme. The substrate binds here and the reaction happens. Now the competitive inhibitor, it looks like substrate. So it can fit into the active site of the enzyme. And what happens is it is competing with the substrate. It's either you or me, either the substrate or the competitive inhibitor. Any one of them can bind to the active site. So when this competitive inhibitor binds, it actually inhibits the reaction to happen. So very importantly, competitive inhibitor diminishes the rate of catalysis by reducing the proportion of enzyme molecules bound to a substrate. At any given inhibitor concentration, competitive inhibition can be relieved by increasing the substrate concentration. Under these conditions, the substrate outcompetes the inhibitor for the active site. So, is very important in answering this question. So we have if we have enough of these substrates, so what will happen? They will outcompete the competitive inhibitor and they will replace all the competitive inhibitor and will bind to the active site of the enzyme in order to make the reaction happen. Okay, so now we will learn about the non-competitive inhibition. In non-competitive inhibition, which also is reversible, the inhibitor and substrate can bind simultaneously to an enzyme molecule at different binding sites. A non-competitive inhibitor acts by decreasing the turnover number rather than by diminishing the proportion of enzyme molecules that are bound to substrate. Let us visualize this as well. So this is the enzyme. This is a site which is not the active site. So the non-competitive inhibitor binds to this site. When they bind to this site, there results in a conformational change in the enzyme. So the active site is available. There is no problem. The substrate can bind, but due to this conformational change, the substrate cannot fit into the active site well in order to make the reaction happen. So it's inhibiting this reaction, but it's not competing. So it is non-competitive. It's not competing with the substrate for the active site, but it is inhibiting the reaction. Non-competitive inhibition, in contrast with competitive inhibition, cannot be overcome by increasing the substrate concentration. So this is very important. Now, we need to know the kinetics, that is, how the rate of reaction, rate of enzyme catalyst reaction in presence of substrate concentration varies when there is only enzyme, when there is enzyme plus competitive inhibitor, and when there is enzyme plus non-competitive inhibitor. So this purple line is only the enzyme is present here. So you can see initially it's with the increase in substrate concentration, the rate increases and finally reaches a maximum rate. Now this green line is enzyme plus the competitive inhibitor. So you can clearly see that in presence of the competitive inhibitor, the initial rate of the reaction is getting affected. It's much less than the enzyme catalyst reaction alone. But if we increase the substrate concentration, at a sufficiently high substrate concentration, we can see that it can completely relieve the enzyme inhibition, and even if the competitive inhibitor is present, the maximum rate can be attained at a high substrate concentration. Now this blue line is the enzyme plus the non-competitive inhibitor. Here you can see that the initial rate of the reaction is affected as well as the maximum rate. It never reaches the maximum rate as when the normal enzyme is present, even at a sufficiently high substrate concentration. So the substrate concentration cannot do much for the non-competitive inhibition, but it can actually outweigh the effect of a competitive inhibitor. Okay. So in the presence of malonate, that means a competitive inhibitor, increase the concentration of succinate, the substrate. If the rate of the reaction increases, then malonate is a non-competitive inhibitor. That is A. And B say the same situation, malonate is a non-competitive inhibitor. So we will have to decide. Just look here carefully. So the malonate is present, okay, in either of this case. And if we increase the substrate concentration, we will have to see if the rate of the reaction increases or not. So where the rate of the reaction increases? Only if it is a competitive inhibitor. If it is a non-competitive inhibitor, the rate of the reaction does not increase even at a sufficiently high substrate concentration. So of course, we can understand from here that A is the right answer choice. So if the rate of the reaction increases, then we can conclude that malonate is a competitive inhibitor. And if the rate of the reaction increases, then malonate cannot be a non-competitive inhibitor, because non-competitive inhibition is not affected by the substrate concentration. C, malonate can alternate between a competitive and non-competitive inhibitor depending on what is required. This is not, of course, true. And talks about a coenzyme. A coenzyme must be affecting the rate of a reaction. Though we already chose the correct answer, but let us just quickly see what is a coenzyme. So for this, we are going to the Khan Academy Enzymes Review. So let us just go to the NCBI book first. Let us just know what is a coenzyme is, and then we will see how the rate of the reaction is affected. So we are in the NCBI book from Stryer. The catalytic activity of many enzymes depends on the presence of small molecules termed cofactors. Okay. So these cofactors can be subdivided into two groups, metals and small organic molecules. Now when these cofactors are small organic molecules, they are known as coenzymes. Often derived from vitamins, coenzymes can either tightly or loosely bound to the enzyme. So this is needed for the enzyme activity. Now whether the coenzyme has anything to do with the rate of the reaction, we need to know that. So here we go, we are in the Khan Academy, enzyme review, factors affecting enzyme activity. So if you can see what are the factors, so mainly it is the temperature, the pH, the enzyme concentration of course, and the substrate concentration. Okay, so we can confidently say that a coenzyme must be affecting the rate of the reaction is not true. So you already chose the correct answer. Thank you all for watching my video. Please like my video and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Sarco Research and Education. Here I post videos on test prep math question from PSAT, SAT and ACT math. I also post epichemistry and biology questions as well as dashboard analysis. Jacquien, see you in the next video then. Happy learning.